My name's Marcus Bulstrode, and I work for the Queensland Department of Agriculture and Fisheries. And I've spent years researching riparian zones in Australia's wet tropics. Today, I want to share with you some of the management practices that we can use on riparian zones, particularly in close proximity to cane. These management practices can allow these riparian zones to flourish and provide all of the benefits that we need for riverbank vegetation and also support the cropping system. Here we are on the riverbank. We can get a very big flood event. The trees will just regenerate into this zone really quickly. This is where they want to grow. So we need to manage these zones in very specific ways. Today we're looking at a site that you often see across the wet tropics. We've got sugarcane and we have riparian forest, and we've got a very weedy zone, a bit of devil's fig, but in particular we've got guinea grass. Guinea grass and these high biomass grasses, we've got hamel, we've got Johnston grass, whole range of them. They're very problematic. They can move into cane, but they also harbour rats and pests that also go into the cane and cause damage. Historically, we've been controlling these grasses with broad spectrum herbicides, and we would basically kill all the plants that the herbicide gets onto. And then in a few months' time or in a next season, we'll be back here again and we'll be treating the same plant again. But what we also get are lots of native plants, so native recruits, seeds that have been dropped down from the trees and the birds that transit through here. And these seedlings eventually turn into these bigger trees. And these bigger trees are what we're after. We want to stabilize this bank. We're trying to provide habitat, and we're trying to shade out the grasses and the other weeds that are potentially a problem for our sugarcane. Here we have an example of what we call a weed-shaped hole. So if I spray this area out with a broad spectrum herbicide, basically turn it back to dirt, then every seed here will have an opportunity to germinate. Within that seed bank, we're going to get some native trees, which is really good, but we're also going to get a whole range of weeds, whatever the weeds are that are present in this area, and they're going to have a chance to come up. If it turns out those weeds are really problematic, then we've got a problem. Here we have Singapore daisy. Singapore daisy is a transformer weed, which means that it will occupy a site and completely capture it and not allow any other plant to come through. So if we've got something like this growing, we're never going to get native regeneration. Our native recruits, tree recruits, can't get through it. So to get rid of this Singapore daisy, all we need to do is to change its growing conditions. And that means moving the shade from just here out over the top of this Singapore daisy. And that means allowing the trees to grow up and put out their lateral branches. Singapore daisy hates shade, and it will be pushed out into a zone where we can manage it. Thunbergia. This is probably the greatest risk, as I see it, to the wet tropics. It scrambles up over the top of big trees, pulls their branches off, and eventually grows up over the top of the tree, the crown of the tree, shades it out, and the whole tree falls down. Certainly something like Thunbergia grandiflora and some of the other scrambling vines, for example, we do have to go in and start to do additional maintenance work. And often it's very small scale work just to make sure that the trees are free to keep growing. We're very lucky here in the wet tropics. In many parts of Australia, you have to spend a huge amount of energy trying to get your trees to grow. We've got the rain, we've got the sun, we've got the nutrients. We just need to control those initial weeds, and in very little time, we end up with examples such as this of fantastic revegetation sites. So what I'm suggesting is to change what you're putting in the spray tank to a selective, something like Verdict, which is haloxyfop methyl ester. And in almost all cases, growers are already using this chemical on their own properties in their legume fallow crop to take out the cane recruits that come up. And that will control the grasses on the riparian edge, but won't damage the native trees. Native trees will go through, form a canopy, shade out the grass. You get rid of the weed that you're trying to control, but you're also supporting that natural regeneration, and that's passive revegetation. simply using the herbicide to select through the plants that you really want to have.